Hello, I wanted to do a quick video today on optimizing viewport playback, specifically with animated characters. So we have here, we just have an animated character. You can see the character is playing back very slowly, just barely at 2 frames per second. And this is just with Eevee on, with subdivision services. So I'm gonna go over some basic tips. These aren't groundbreaking tips or anything, but just like a good checklist to have for questions I often get about optimizing, specifically with animated characters. Firstly, don't use material preview or rendered view. Sometimes it's necessary to have the shaders visible, but you'll get a lot more playback with here. You can see we gained about a frame just from that. If you want to do a full render playback or even like with textures, you can do that with the Workbench engine. For those who don't know, Workbench is just basically this viewport render engine. And you can use this for playbacks. And so if we do this, you can actually give texture. So you can see, you can actually get all the textures just from the render. Oh, we don't have a camera in here. I took it out. So if we render that, so it has the textures and everything. So use solid view, don't use material rendered view when playing back in the app. Otherwise, just render it out. The next thing is disabling modifiers. I found that when it comes to performance in a scene, when I'm optimizing customer scenes, most of the time it's a modifier that's being slow. Geometry nodes can be guilty of this, but the important thing is with characters, especially when you're using an armature modifier, since this armature modifier is updating every frame to deform your character, every modifier after it also has to update per frame. So the important thing is to try to disable these whenever possible. And so in this case, I'm going to disable the subdivisions. So was it 3 frames per second before? We're already at max speed. This will make a big difference. Obviously, this is a contrived example, but in most of the cases when I'm optimizing a scene or an animation, it's the modifiers that are slowing it down. And again, if the armature wasn't affecting the character and I had subdivisions on, let's say I just deleted that. It's not affecting anything. So the subdivision of itself isn't evaluating every frame because the character is not moving every frame. But because of the armature, it is. Let me see if I can crank up the frames per second. So we're getting at 60, about 60 frames per second in this case. There's a new option with Blender 4, I can't remember which version it is, but definitely in 4.2, there's this new option called normals. So basically what this means is any custom normals that are added to the mesh or character is being recalculated with the deformation. That can slow things down. You can tell Blender to skip that calculation. And so the normals will be slightly off, but it'll be a lot faster in the playback. It's jumping up a little bit. I'd say it's a little closer to 70. But this is a common way to speed things up. There are some add-ons that do this as well for older versions of Blender, but for Blender 4 onward, you can just use this checkbox. You don't need to do anything else. The other thing is proxy rigs. So there's actually a fantastic video online of how to create your own proxy rigs. But in short, it's basically taking your deforming character and splitting it up from this one deforming character and splitting it up into multiple non-deforming pieces. This wouldn't be used for the render. This is purely just so you can get the fastest, smoothest playback in your viewport as possible. I made an add-on to automate this process of creating proxy rigs called Proxy Plus. So you do is you take your character, and if it has a rig attached to it, but then you just have it generate this rig mesh proxy, splits it into pieces. And so just with that, but you can see it's getting up to even 90 and 100 frames per second at some point. And the reason it's so fast is because all these pieces are not deforming. They're just pieces of the original mesh that are duplicated and then just following the bone underneath it. So it's not deforming. You can see there's no deforming piece. You could even, let's try with the subdivisions on. Didn't really affect the frame rate either. Because these are not deforming per frame, this subdivision is pretty much done once and then the object's just rotated. But I'll link that video in the description that goes how to do this manually just to feel like this isn't a total plug. Because I want you to feel like you can do it yourself And then if you're in a case where you do need something a little more automated, then you can try the Proxy Plus add-on. Proxies are very important. I feel like that's something that a lot of beginners, when they're making these gigantic scenes and high quality, high geometry characters, they don't realize the need to have these proxy objects. And this can make a big difference in how quick you're able to iterate and work on your characters and animations because you're working with all this dense geometry that's slowing down your computer. This is a quick video on optimizing your animation playback in the viewport. Hope you find it useful.